Very interesting table. It is in Hebrew, but I will try to explain to you every word. So it starts from a question. In fact, this is Mr. Chaim Sadeh. The basis of this table is Mr. Chaim Sadeh, with many additions, which I found afterwards in the same place. So he asks a question, Mi hu Mashiach, Messiah, Hashem of God. Unbelievable. Once in the Torah, who is the Messiah of God? Amazingly, if you remember my YouTube not long ago, when Dr. Schwarzman asked the same question, who is the Messiah? He was answered, Ben Ishai, son of Jesse. So exactly comes here, son of Jesse. Interesting to point out that Mr. Chaim Sadeh found also son of David. We have here David, but the son of David is later on down. So this is my program, which can do only this way, the table. So what more we have in this table? So the first thing we said, son of Jesse. Now, as you remember, many times I told you that Messiah have few names, like Inon, Menachem, and also Shiloh. All appears here, our Rabbi tells us that the names, don't mean these are different Messiahs, but each name represents what is really the goal, the duty, or the destiny of Messiah. So you have here parallel, Menachem. Menachem means in Hebrew, will comfort. Now Israel, Jews need a lot of comfort after what is going on. Mismol from the left, people here, you have left, yeah, left, all these leftists, anti-Semites. Yeah, all over history up to today. So the Messiah will comfort us. So you have Menachem. Then you have a very small skip of Shiloh, Shiloh. Yeah, this is one of the names, Shiloh, you know, at Yavo Shiloh. It represents the appreciation of the world to the Messiah, Shiloh, that they will give him present, realizing how much the Jews contributed to the world, not only Nobel Prize, but many, many other things. Yeah, they are light to the nations, as the Bible, as Isaiah said, yes, it will be light to the nations, right? Now, what more you have here, which is also very, very interesting, you have here also Cyrus, Koresh. Why? Because Cyrus was called the Messiah of God. Isaiah 45, because he was helping Israel to settle, and even he allowed them to build the temple. Yes, somebody like this also now, Donald Trump, but you know, the Satan, the Democrat, which is an American value Democrat, we don't believe in the Torah, not in God, so definitely came and disturbed all these things. And Israel have again problems. So, okay, depends on Israel. They will keep the Torah and mitzvot properly, as is written in mitzvot. Yes, then definitely it will be different, because God said, if you will keep the Torah, then you will have your land, you will have security in the land, you will have peace in your land. No, but if you don't keep the Torah, especially with this government, today the leftists who don't allow Orthodox even to be in the government. So, no doubt, the troubles will come very strongly. Now, what is also very interesting, if you follow my YouTube, we mentioned that the Messiah, son of Joseph, you have Joseph, yeah, which is Ephraim, comes here, basically, is different people who helped Israel. Esther, Queen Esther in Purim, she saved the Jewish people because they listened to her, they believed in God, and they repented, they kept the Torah, and the terrible decree of Haman, extermination, annihilation of Jewish people, turned to be Purim. Yeah, so Esther comes here because she's also, according to our rabbi, the Vilna Gaon says she is sparks of son of Joseph, yeah, because it means son of Joseph, sparks, and Esther, the queen, is one of them. Then you have also Matityahu, you see in black Matityahu, why? Because he is a Matityahu, the Maccabean, and he saved Jews, yeah, from the Greeks, We know the great danger because the Greeks, the philosophy, against the Jews, against the Torah. So Matityahu, also Rabbi Selas in Kabbalah, that is Ed Sparks of son of Joseph. Unbelievable. So you have Esther, you have Matityahu. Now, what more you have? Also very interesting, you have the expression that we had in Purim. If you remember, we mentioned many times that our rabbis tell us that the redemption of this exile that we are in by Edom and Ishmael will be with the Messiah, who will bring us Shua, Ateshua, will bring us their salvation. Because this is exactly what is in about Purim, that their salvation of Purim will be eternal. It means that all over history, this salvation of Purim will be. So we have exactly the same situation. We have the Hamani, who is exactly Hamani of Haman of today. We say that the name Haman himself, according to Kabbalah, represents very strong judgment. Yeah, because Mem Nun are the letters of strength and five. So Hamani of today is the Haman of the past. Both of them wanted to annihilate the Jewish people, exterminate them. So we hope that, like at that time, everything turned to the finish of Haman. So it will be the same thing as Amaniah, and all this, but all depends on Israel. The children of Israel comes here, who keeps the Torah. But if it's today, like we have this kind of government against the Torah, who knows what will be. Hoping that Jews will realize soon what is the Torah, that the only God, only the Torah can save them. Amazing, you have here also this year, Tav Shin Pe Aleph, 5781, 2021, we said that is a suitable time to Messiah. And in the center, we have here really engaged Teshuvah, means the A later on, but repentance. In the center, because this was the Rambam, the Maimonides said that only the merit of doing Shuva when Jews return to the Torah, keep the Torah, then they will be saved, they will have salvation. And this is what really we need badly this time. So very interesting and significant table for our time.